Hey, everybody. So glad that you joined us. I pray that you'll be encouraged and strengthened with the Word of God. I've been talking about one another's, the one another's of the Bible, the one another's of the New Testament. And I think God's just really putting an emphasis on this. This was really strong on my heart. I wrote them. You can catch up in Daily Bread. We did about 15 of those in total. So I don't know when you're getting this, but I'm telling you that I believe there's an emphasis right now from the Spirit of God on how to help one another, how to do for one another. And if you'll begin to think about somebody else beside yourself, because too much self-thinking leads to oppression and depression. Too much self-thinking leads to self-centeredness and pride. So we've got to think about other people. And so the Bible is very good at keeping us on mission. The Bible is very good at keeping us on task. And one of the things that it talks about is the one another's. And so I want to give you, we may look at one or two, but the first one to look at is 1 Thessalonians 5:11. It says, "Wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also you do." So the Bible talks about edifying someone. What does it mean to edify? Well, when Jude 20 says you pray in the Holy Ghost, you edify or build up yourself in your most holy faith. So when I'm edifying somebody else, I'm building them up. So what can I do in this particular context of the Word of God? What can I do to build somebody else up? What can I say? Well, we know this, the Word of God is what will really help somebody, which will really strengthen somebody. So if I'm gonna build somebody up, I'm gonna give them tools from the Word of God, and you can help somebody with exhorting them with Scripture. So wherefore, build one another, edify or build somebody up. Ephesians 4:29 says, "Let no corrupt talk come out of your mouth." Let no corrupt talk come out of your mouth. Let no corrupt talk come out of your mouth, but only such as good for building up as it fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those that hear. So we're not supposed to do anything, let any corrupt talk come out of our mouth. Well, that's interesting. I don't think that happens as a whole today. Let no corrupt talk. What is corrupt? Things that erode, things that pull down, things that destroy, corruption. Corrupt talk, like you can think of rust, how it corrodes. But the Bible says, instead of that, I want your word seasoned with grace to the edifying, to the building up. And so we have to make sure that as we're ministering or talking to even our spouse, our family, our friends, our coworkers, our people that go to church together, we may need to make sure that we're building one another up. We're encouraging one another. Then another one is found in Hebrews 3:13. It says, "But exhort one another daily while it's called today, lest any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin." And so this one to me is a big one, because it says exhort one another daily. You and I are supposed to help each other every day. Wow, that's a big thing, because it's not weekly, it's not monthly, it's not every Sunday. It says do it every day. Why? Because it goes on to say that any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. So what I know is that sin is out there trying to steal and kill and destroy. Sin is trying to pull us away. But one of the cures for that is that we have people around us that will exhort us, that will encourage us. So whether you know it or not, when you're positive to someone, when you edify someone, when you exhort someone with the Word of God, when you encourage them every day, every day. That's why we're sending out these videos every day. We want to encourage you every day. And every day when you watch them, every day when you hear the Word of God, it helps keep the sin away. It helps keep the problems away. And so if I exhort you, then I want you to turn around, because I don't know everybody you know. Everybody's not watching me, you're watching me. And so what I need you to do is then your sphere of influence, I need you to exhort them. I need you to encourage them. You can forward this, but also with it, you can say some things, because they know you. And so I want you to edify someone today. I want you to exhort someone today. I want you to encourage someone today. And in doing so, you're going to please the Lord. You're going to sow a good seed. You're going to lift people up, and you're going to keep people from falling into the trap of sin, and which is going to mess up their life. And you can be someone who helps people all around them. You are a minister of reconciliation. You have a word of encouragement. You are meant to strengthen those around you, and you are spiritual. And so I want you to get about doing the work of the Lord. And I pray that you're encouraged and strengthened and healed and blessed and prosperous, blessed coming in, blessed going out. I just trust that everything is working out for you, because God perfects everything that concerns you. I'll see you again next time.